Hello guys, my name is Bonnie and welcome to one of my sit down videos that I haven't done in a long time. This is a Fitbit. Have any of you guys got one of these? Let me just straighten this camera out. Thanks for subscribing to my channel and watching my videos. I appreciate it very much. I'm from Perth, Western Australia, and I will give you a bit of an introduction in this video, like a guide about moving and relocating to Perth. I see that you guys have liked one of my videos that I've done about dodgy suburbs in Perth. Haha, I wanted to warn you. Nearly 5,000 viewers, so thanks. And maybe this will be another video, like an introduction that continues from that video that you might enjoy also. So, if you're moving to Perth from, let's say, English speaking countries, it is easier than non-English speaking countries. If you're moving from Perth from like England, UK, New Zealand, Canada, America, it is much easier to get a visa, to get work and everything else, rather than, let's say, from Thailand and from places like that. My mum works in this kind of area, so I've learned that through her job, because I used to help her out. I've learned a lot about that field. When you move to Perth, you have to be careful that you're on the right visa, because immigration can come knocking on your door and say, "Knock, knock, it's us, you have to go to a detention facility," which are not great, you do not want to stay there. They're at Christmas Island and in Northern. Avoid that if you can. There are a few different visas that you can apply for. There is a tourist visa, which you can't work on. You can visit family and just travel around. There is a student visa, which you can study only on, strictly study. They usually stay at local accommodation, like university accommodation, or with other students in a shared house or a facility or something like that. There are working visas, recognized skills visas, refugee and migrant visas, and should I say legal immigrants? refugee visa is the one that I came on, and that was in 1995. So I got my citizenship 2 years exactly after. But now, when you come to Australia, you have to pass all these questions about Australia before you get your citizenship. Permanent residents, they can get Centrelink payments, but if you're not one, you can't. So you can also research all of this information on Centrelink websites and immigration websites, so it might make more sense to you than what I do. What else was I going to say? That there are different type of accommodations and different type of websites for accommodations in Perth. And you can stay at student accommodation. Sometimes international students just go to the university room, where you can be sharing dormitories with like six people and you have your own room and stuff like that. Is that something you want to stay in, or do you want to stay in like a smaller house where you can study a bit more and focus a bit more? You know what I mean? If you're here looking for work, you can stay in a hostel, and maybe the hostel can help you find some information A lot of people stay 2 or 3 months in a hostel, backpackers, which is not the greatest hygiene. I've stayed at many backpackers in my time. I still do backpacking around Australia when I can, but COVID makes it hard to travel. So backpackers accommodation can help you look for work, and they can help you connect you with agencies that can help you look for work. And you can also have internet access and you can look for other accommodation. Overall about Perth. Perth has very accurate public transport and very clean buses. In Perth, if you're not there right that minute, the bus will take off. Yeah, I'm not lying, it's literally true. And if you need to look at a website, Transpert, and it will tell you exactly where the buses are and when they will be at your next bus stop where you're waiting. So you better be there, otherwise you miss out. We have Uber services, Ola, and something else, I'm not sure what exactly. We also have taxis, but they're not in much in use with young people who have iPhones. Ubers is used much more in Perth than taxis. They're more for older people because older people have discounts and blind people also have discounts. So public transport is great, but you got to be very organized. The trains run every 15 minutes during the week and during the weekend even. It's a very friendly city in terms of getting to places. There is no such thing as it's far away in Perth. Like, I can even get to Joondalup in 30 minutes. Joondalup is very up north and I live in the city. I'm filming from a city apartment. Everything is close from one place to another here. Yeah. University is expensive. We're lacking international students at the moment because of COVID. International students are not coming. Some are stuck here. Very expensive and very long and big commitment. That is why I'm not in the university. Now, this COVID thing has put TAFE prices down. So the skills that are in demand are half price or even free to study at TAFE. A lot of people have lost jobs to COVID and they have gone back to study at TAFE. Yeah, it's just the way that the situation is at the moment. But what can I say? It's a great city to live in. It's very clean. We do have issues with homeless, but every city out there has it. And we are very safe with COVID. We have quite hotel quarantine case that pops up sometimes. And we have to go into like a 3-day lockdown or whatever. But 3 days better than a week. What else can I say about this city? The weather is good. The weather is not bad. Even the winters are not so bad here, like in Melbourne and places. We have had a very long summer. It went on and on. There are also places that are warmer than usual. Like if you travel up north, you'll get very, very warm weather. Not sure what you want to do when you come here, but you can comment below and let me know. Maybe I can help you. I am a travel agent that is not working at the moment. And yeah, my name is Bonnie. I live in Perth City, obviously. I've been to Melbourne many times. I also like Melbourne and Victoria. There are good places to socialize in Perth as well. You can find social groups on meetup.com, all sorts of things. And overall, I think it's a nice city. It's not a retirement city, although they say that. I will show you my apartment that I'm renting in this city through community housing. See, this is my apartment. Do you like my style? I'll catch you later. Good night.